Hey guys, you're Booker Fans, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Grandma, where last time I left off, I beat Spurs in the league, and I advanced in the FA Cup with a win over Watford. In this episode, I'm at Wembley. Yeah, it's the League Cup final against Manchester City. Not sure why it's showing me Sami Nasri. He's probably not going to play. He's not even at Man City. This game. You tell it to download the latest squads and it completely fucks up. Seriously, I told it to download the latest squads and somehow I completely forgot to put Nasri on it as well. Ah well, what can you do? So yeah. Also, Chelsea have played a few games in the league since the last episode. If you saw the last episode, why didn't you? It was amazing. I made it. Duh. Go watch it. Now that those guys who didn't see it, they're going to go watch it. It probably had something going on that prevented them from watching it when it got released. Now that they're gone, we can talk about it. So yeah. Chelsea were on 22 games since the end of the last episode, in between after my game against Spurs and now. Chelsea have played 4 games, which means they've gone up to 26 games, and now I have the game in hand. So, there's that.
Financial fair play regulations.
Would you like to know what happened in those games? Oh, I bet you do. If I knew how to do sound effects, this is where I add in a drum roll. But I don't know how to do that. Just imagine what. In those 4 games, Chelsea picked up 1 win and 3 draws. Yep, they only picked up 6 points from 4 games.
Here's the shot. Credit for taking on the shot.
Which is bad. Which is very bad. Well, it's very bad for Chelsea. It is fantastic. So they only cut the lead to 22 points. So basically, well, let's just say what it is. It is 25, because, let's be honest, I don't care who the game in hand is against, I'm going to be winning it. So, I'm 25 points ahead. After that game, will be 12 games remaining. So a total of 36. Which means I will only need 4 more wins at most to guarantee the Premier League title. So in overall I need 5 more wins max. And that's if Chelsea don't fuck up again. Because they clearly fucked up. I don't know who took those 6 points from Chelsea that they lost in those 3 games that they drew. But fantastic. Thank you very much, Pitch. I don't know which teams you are because I don't care. And, well, as I said, I don't care. But you are in my mind, whoever you are. You know who you are. I don't care, but, you know, the game. Maybe I'll look, but, don't bang on that happening. Mane.
Nathaniel
Klein. Hammers and Milner. Milner! Looking for it! James Milner! Against the former club of He's looking to lift his first bit of silverware with the captain's armband. And he scores the opening goal. 1-0. The veteran Englishman gets it past the young lion, as it were, for Jack Butland. Poor Joe Hart, he just can't catch a break, can he? In real life, Pep is replacing him with fucking Claudio Bravo, who's just no good at doing whatever, playing the style that Pep wants to play. That was a fucking good use of all that money. And in the game, he's replaced him with freaking Jack Butland. Seriously, the dude can't catch a break.
Bit of a surprise, but perhaps it's the extra
work. Firmino.
And here comes the counter attack.
Sturridge 2-0! Two former Manchester City players banging the goals. Was Milner and now Sturridge. Good pass from me. Well, Mane, he did a very good job with the jumping at just the right time so the ball got to Sturridge. Although, let's be honest, Mane would have probably scored it anyway. Now Sturridge bags his fourth of the competition.
Nicolas Otamendi.
It was actually his good performances in this competition that got him the spot over Divock Origi. Since then, he has been in the starting lineup, performing well almost every single time. Save for an odd hiccup there, you know, again, but every player has one of those games. So that's not something I'm going to hold against, Daniel. He to get that once. Another great each show of intelligence and skill from Daniel Sturridge.
Challenges for the ball. Guthrie Boney.
Alaba. Hammers and Milner. Firmino. Turns. Mane! Oh, cliche with the block to prevent 3-0. Oh, but the corner could wield 3-0 anyway. Goes up! Oh, Matip set our fine storage, but I think it was cliche again who got in the way. Might be an Otamendi. Couldn't quite see the number. Happened so fast. Sadio Mane. He's got two players on his ass. He's lost them. Sadio Mane. Oh, Zabaleta with a good challenge. Come on. Good error, Joe. Yes? No, it's fault to continue. Hello, there. Oh my god. Oh my gosh! How? How did that not go in? God's sake. There's the trophy. So you've had two shots. When did they have two shots? I must have fucking blinked and missed them.
Here goes the second half. We're underway.
Yeah, Daniel Sturridge.
Further into it,
maybe
tiredness will play a
part. Oops, in. Oh, just too high for Sadio Mane. Hey, it's coming back to Sturridge though. Yo, get out of the way! Firmino, man, what was that?
Well, the goalkeeper will hope that it stays like that throughout the game. reading of the play, anticipating the pass.
Ah, come on. No.
But he's doing well.
I'll be happy with that first 45 minutes. It was a good goal.
Are you shitting me? Oh, that's where he is playing. I didn't even know it's in there. That means he's playing over Raheem. Ha! 50 million for a bench player. Or well spent money, man. Just to see. And it doesn't be the freaking cup. Because Sadio Mane scored, which means it's 3-0. Oh, and it is more than likely game over. Not sure why I say it's so fancy, but I did. Deal with it.
It's a really good finish.
That's given them a comfortable situation.
No, he had to make his
Vincent Kompany
effect on this competition. Ninja.
Half an hour to go.
Sturridge. Run straight to Clichy.
Chan. Subs getting ready.
Firmino. I wonder if that'll be a yellow card when he plays next stop. That will be a yellow card for Otamendi. Yeah. Dumbass. What did you think you were going to get?
Otamendi. Well, you run the risk when you...
Your shitty neck tattoo. Think you badass? You don't. Oh, here comes Silky Ookie. Hello, Silky Ookie. What's up? Sorry, you've arrived at a bad time. It's 3-0. Not sure how much you can do about that. I'm hopeful the computer will bring on Raheem so he can witness the devastating loss firsthand. Please do that, computer, please. I'm kind of hoping he didn't get injured. And Delph did get booked for that foul earlier. Nice. Oh, that's another yellow card. This time it's Clichy who's going in the book. Nick, naughty boy.
Cope with it well defensively.
Coutinho! Straight in. Brilliant. Hey! Sadio Mane! Oh my god. How many times is that going to work? That's 3 out of 4 times, that's worth the perfection. I wonder if that goes down as a Sewell assist. Oh, brilliant. It's definitely a Sadio Mane second. It's a Liverpool 4th. The cup is secure. Well, it was probably secure at 3-0, to be honest. But yeah. That was fantastic. I actually have to check. Just out of curiosity, does that go down as an assist? Probably doesn't, to be honest. Aw, man, it doesn't. Firmino bagging himself 2 assists. Check you out, Roberto. Looks like he's gonna be man of the match at the moment. No sign of a change yet from Manchester City. I really hope he's not injured. That would take the fun out of this a bit. Just a bit. It's still fun that I'm winning and he's going to win the cup. But I would rather for that FFP he's be on the pitch to witness it firsthand. Oh yes, avoiding the challenges like a boss. That's Daniel Sturridge! Straight to keep.
Oh, he's lost the ball.
got there? What happened? Friggin' Butland took a fucking walk and he almost was made to pay for it. What was that? Yo, are they on all-out attack? What the hell is Otamendi doing? And Clichy as well. Yo, they're on all-out attack. Are they fucking stupid? They're all all-out attack. 4-0 down in the final minute. Hey! Sterling, what's the score? Come on, enjoy the fun, you traitorous son of a bitch.
Because there's three added minutes.
One eye and an eel always miss the red head, you scumbag prick. Enjoy watching us lift the trophy while you get a crappy runners up medal. Oh, because that's all traitors deserve. You too, Dolph. I'm not an Aston Villa fan, but you're a traitor as well. Simon. I think you both deserve jack shit, and you're gonna fucking like it. Ha!
These are special moments for a very successful team. Congratulations to them. Wonderful scenes of joy here. And no wonder they're milking the moment. Want to make absolutely the most of this.
Oh wow, the League Cup doesn't deserve a fucking podium. Just fucking put it. Just put the thing on the fucking grass. Yes, no one will take any fucking. No one gives a shit. It's the League Cup. Whey! League Cup or not, that is the first trophy of this career mode. And that has got to put a smile on the board's faces, I imagine. Yeah? First of three, man. First of three. Because you can bet I will be adding the FA and the league. Quick train session. Yeah. There you can see in the corner for Chelsea are up to 26 games. And you can see they're on 53 points. Leicester is the other game in this episode. Oh no! A7, goodbye. Anyone who drops below 90, he has to be released. Sorry. I have so many of you, I need to be brutal. Needs to be brutal. Speaking of brutal, how bad is this? And who is it? It's Emre Can for 3 days with a dead leg. Brilliant. Does he even... He won't even miss the game. That's... Brilliant. The logic there for game. Way! I'm 90 rated! Fucking hell. Oh, look at this. Look at that. Nice and green, too. Ooh, yeah! Badass green. On the array. Probably should not start. Emre Can, so I'll start the hood. James Milner is going to turn 20 Braves. Uh-oh. That's not good. He's starting to go down. It's not what I wanted to see. That means your time is coming, dude. Sooner or later, you're going to be a star. I'm hoping Emery can see it. James can see it out to the end of the season. For how well he's played. He's not just in-game, but in real life as well. Well, I had my doubts about when we signed James Milner. How wrong was I? I will fully admit, I was totally convinced we'd fucked up signing James Milner. We didn't sign James Milner, we signed James Milner. Much better. anything can be done when you say it with a fucking accent.
The dominant team in the 70s and the 80s, but not too much, certainly not in league terms. Since
fact, he's become our best left back. It's an interesting turn of events that probably none of us saw coming. When I say he's our best left back, I mean in real life. IRL. Then again, he doesn't really have any competition. He don't have any other left backs. Well, we joke almost, but he's still recovering from injury. And Alberto Moreno is not a fucking left back. Heck, if he was, he might actually know how to defend. But yeah, he doesn't know how to do that, so yeah, not a defender. Might be a decent mid, but don't need a wide midfielder. So yeah, a rumor is kind of pointless. Especially because, you know, he's supposed to be a defender and he doesn't know how to defend. That's an issue.
And they've got to try and get the better of the best defence. It's going to be very hard for them to do that, but we wait and see with a fair amount of anticipation.
They just haven't been creating chances, the home team here, and when they have, they've been fluffing them, so I just wonder whether they're going to be able to do something better here.
Well, that's wrong. That's completely wrong.
Shot, maybe.
Put them in front.
Huh. So the game is completely messed up, those stats. I have not only scored 4 goals. Up until that, I had only conceded 4 goals. That is goal number 5. For Musa there. Leicester showing why they're the reigning Premier League champions. Still hard to get used to saying that.
Good control. Oh, it's offside.
Well, as a striker, you expect to get the benefit.
Are you? It's like someone to come offside, so no party right now. Sayamani! Ah!
Rushing it here. Moving to the other.
Breathe. Play! Ah, oh, Manny! He's closed down by the defender so quickly. He is not. It's actually batshit crazy how quick they close him down. Milner, James. That's not what I expected from you, man. Really good opportunity.
Could be dangerous. In quickly. It's nicely worked until that point.
Milner. Coutinho. Mane. Against Hoof. Get it to Sturridge. Oh, Mendy stuck his French leg in there. I can't even be mad because in Ultimate Team he's done that a few times for me. On the occasion I decide to play Ultimate Team.
Stretch the opposition using the wider areas here. That looked very good indeed, but the...
Oh yes, Alaba kept it in. Go! De Hood. James Milner. Philip Coutinho.
Just working away.
Pass to Mane if he can avoid losing it to Simpson, and he does. Coutinho. Coutinho! 1-1! Just before the break. Fantastic time to score. Thank you very much, Phil.
Oh. In terms of shots, there's a real gap between these two sides, reflected in the recent goal.
He ran completely past Hoop as if to say, yeah, what are you going to do about it? And the answer was nothing. He missed the challenge and can't prevent goal number 6 of the season for Phil Coutinho. And that perfectly timed goal cancels out Moose's opener. So we're level at the break. We'd prefer to be winning, but hey, you can't have everything you want. Oh, and Chelsea are playing. Hey, but they're late game, it looks like it. Against West Ham. West Ham could get some points off them. Of course, I need to focus on not dropping points myself. Can we capitalize on Chelsea if they drop points, if I drop points as well? Oh, I said a lot of drops there. Mane! Ah!
Liverpool will get the throw.
Hey!
Coming up for you.
And there's Milner. Come on. Dude. Bobby Firmino, go on, Bobby! Go on, Bobby! Yes! Sturridge! Fuck! Dude. James Milner. Oh, what a back! All the fancy stuff is coming out now. Oh, Coutinho. Oh. Penalty! Penalty! Hello! Are you paying attention? Do you not see Morris is completely floor or Coutinho in the box? It's 1-1, so don't give me that I'm winning comfortably. So you gave it the, you didn't give the decision bullshit. You were looking right at it, so don't tell me he didn't see it.
Nathaniel Clyne. Well, they're building steadily here.
What a load of bullshit. Yeah, that's a foul. Colo. Hey, you don't deserve that name. You are not. That's the Torre.
They cope with it well defensively.
James Milner! Oh, imagine if that had somehow gone in.
That's neatly done. Good challenge by the defender. Very good control, though.
Go on, Bobby. Firmino. Oh, going up again. It's the Colo wannabe. Hey. Oh, yes! Oh! It was a... Holy shit, what the fuck? That almost went in! What the hell? The Colo imposter trying to fucking backpass. He almost completely failed. Firmino. That was hilarious. Sturridge. Oh yes! The ball! Mane! No! Oh, Sadio, I'm sorry, but you have to go off after that. You have to go off. Emre Moore, on you come. And so comes up, also coming on is Jorginho Wijnaldum. Sturridge, I'm putting my faith in you to get this win. Well, not just you. More chance for the youngster! He got it! He fucking got it! Get in! Get in, Emery! That's what I'm talking about!
Much deserved the
way what a way to make peak. I don't think that's his first appearance. Is this his first Premier League appearance? And he might have scored the winner? And what might be a crucial winner as well from the youngster. Of course, still plenty of time to be played. That is definitely his first Premier League goal, and he couldn't have scored it at a better time.
It's Leicester City who are going to make the substitution.
With his first involvement in the game as well.
Menace to it. Leicester looking to get the ball up the other end of the field quickly. Well, the time for patient short passes.
Wijnaldum is somehow outpaced Jamie Vardy. Not sure how he did that. I'll take it. And Hoof concedes the corner. More. The block by Braithwaite. Hey. The ball goes right across the box. Sewell picks it up. Looking for Sturridge. Yes. No. Are you kidding me? Yes. Oh, yes. Daniel Sturridge puts it in eventually. 3-1. That will be the game. Emery Moore almost scored again, if not for the block. I think it was actually the fake Colo who blocked it. It was indeed. He 3-1. But the ball comes to Daniel Sturridge, and despite Ekasper Schmeichel's best attempt, it's in the back of the net. And despite the fact that Leicester were at 1.1 nothing up, that seems so very long ago. But right about now.
And now, Huth. Ball played to Mendy. The time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Came in with a challenge and the ball broke free.
Sturridge. More. Oh, he avoids the challenge. Sturridge. Oh, Mendy here with the challenge. It's to avoid 4-1 right there. And unless we score from the corner, which is not going to happen. Or we might score from this corner, because apparently it's giving me another one. It took another deflection that I didn't see. It's very hard to see these deflections that the game is picking up, but I'm not complaining. The Hoof wins the ball! Oh, Daniel Sturridge, it is 4-1! Daniel Sturridge wraps it up even further. And it was at 3-1. He adds another for 4-1, because why the ever-loving fuck not? And the standard Daniel Sturridge arm celebration.
And that's a win.
And yeah. Solid victory. Chelsea and West Ham just started as I finished, so they were indeed the late game.
Liverpool 4. Manchester United 4. Bournemouth 1.
Oh, they won. Boo! Boo, boo, boo forever!
West Ham United 1. Chelsea 3.
Ah.
So what do those results mean to the league table? At the top of the table remain
whatever
78 points with a game in hand. Ah.
that will be the end of this episode. Pretty successful episode because it contained a victory in the Cavalon Cup final, which means I've claimed my first trophy of the season. And the Premier League title is not far behind in jump. And because
with 39 points, but only behind.
With 12 games remaining for me, I'm 22 points clear. And Chelsea are just there up shit creek without a paddle. Join me in the next episode where I will get hopefully much closer to the league title where I play Burnley and also have the quarterfinal of the FA Cup against Aston Villa unless there's another rescheduling. And until then, thanks for watching. I'm enjoying. Smash the like button if you did enjoy, hit subscribe if you're new, and until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace!